Hi students, welcome to our mathematics class. In this class I am going to explain about comparison of decimal numbers. Here I am doing one more video for this to avoid your difficulties. You see, once again I am going to explain about comparison of decimal numbers. You see, 97.6 and 6.3, which is the greatest and which is the smallest? If you say, if you ask the question, which is the greatest? You see, first compare the whole number part. As per the steps, as per the rules, compare the whole number part. Here whole number part is greater, so we can say it is greater. First number only, first decimal only greater. In second one, here whole number part, which is the greatest, that is only greater. 8 is whole number part, 8 and 6, 8 is greater. So you don't worry about the remaining decimals. Only first compare whole number part. Which whole number part is greater? That only, that decimal only greater. 8 is whole number and 6 is whole number. So this number, this decimal is greater. And see next one, 8 and 30. Here 30 is the greatest whole number than 8. So then this decimal is greater. Now in case this decimal 6.99 and 6.999, your whole number part is equal. Listen carefully, whole number part is equal. When whole number part is equal, we cannot decide which is greatest, which is smallest. We cannot decide. Then check for first decimal. First decimal is 9 and 9. Now here also we cannot decide. When whole number part is same and first decimal also same, then go to second decimal. Second decimal, check, compare second decimal. Second decimal also same. When whole number part is same, first decimal is same, second decimal is same, then go to third decimal. Third decimal not there, here anything, here 9 is there. Not there anything is mean 0. No decimal at the end. That means it is 0. 0 and 9. Now we can say 9 is greater than 0. So this is the greatest decimal than this. No decimal at the end means that is 0. Already I explained. We can write as per required zeros at the end. Next one, 2539. Easily we can say whole number part is greater, so this big, this decimal is greater. Next one, here 1111, whole number part is same and decimal, first decimal is also same and second decimal also same. We cannot decide now which is greatest, which is small. Now third decimal not there anything, here 0 there, here not there also 0, equal to 0. No decimal means it is 0 only. So here also 0. So that is why these two are equal. No difference. Equivalent decimals. Last end point you can take zeros. Required zeros. Now these two are equal. You may think that 27 and 270 different. No. No. It is end. At the end no decimal means that is equal to 0 only. At the end of the decimal nothing is there means it is 0 only. Now it is 27 and 270, 0.27 and 0.270, both are equal only. Don't think it is 27 and 270, it is also 2270, because last how many want, you can write zeros. How many zeros you want, you can write zeros if you want. So both are equal. Now here, you can compare remaining questions and answers are given. Now I am going to say, explain main arrangement of decimal numbers, ascending order and descending order. See, ascending order, small to big. Listen carefully, small to big. Now why I am writing small? See, this is the smallest number. Here to decide smallest or greatest, first compare whole number part. Whole number part means before decimal number, before decimal point, the number before decimal is called whole number part. So before decimal 0 there, before decimal 0 there, before decimal 0 there, all whole numbers are 0 only. Now then if whole numbers are same, then compare first decimal. First decimal 2 there, 3 there, 4 there. So 3, 3, 4 are greater. So smaller is 2. smaller is 2 2. Now confusion about this 2 2, which is greatest, which is smallest. Now second decimal, if first decimal also same, then go to second decimal, 3 and 4. So here only we can decide this is the smallest. Second decimal, if first whole number part, see first, if whole numbers are same, then check first decimals. If first decimal also same, then check, compare third, second decimal. Yes, second decimal, this is small. So you don't think about remaining, only first whole number part and decide. Now whole number part same, then first, then check for first decimal. If first decimal also same, then check for compare second decimals. Now we can say this is smallest and this is greater than this. So then now next one, whole number parts are same and decimal, then first decimal, first decimal, this is small, this is greater. So this is greater than this, so this is smaller, this is greater. Now in case confusion about these two, whole number part is same, first decimal also same, then compare second decimal, compare second decimal. Here second decimal is small, this is second decimal is bigger. So this is the smallest, this is the greatest out of these two. Next, here whole number part is same, then first decimal. See first decimal, this is the greater. So this is the greatest. When whole number part is not same, you can decide there only. If whole number part is same, then first decimal, first check first decimals, compare first decimals and decide. No need to see remaining. Then 3 and 4. Here only we decides. Here only we decide. First, by seeing first decimal only we can decide this is the greater, this is the smallest. Now about these two, which is smaller, which is greatest. Now see 0 4 0 4. Whole number parts are same, so we cannot decide which is greater and which is smaller. And decimal, first decimal also same. Here also we cannot decide which is smaller, which is greatest. Now second decimal, second decimal, then if whole number parts are same, first decimal also same, then compare second decimals. Second decimal 2 and 3. Now we can decide this is smallest, this number is, this total decimal is smallest, this total decimal is greater, because second decimal is different. Second decimal, which is the second decimal greater, that is only greater here in these two. Why? Whole numbers same, we cannot decide. If whole numbers are different, you can, here only you can decide. Whole numbers are same, not decide. First decimal also same, not decide. Then see second decimal. In case second decimal also same, then go to third decimal. Check third decimal, compare third decimal. Such a way we can write ascending order. Similarly, descending order. Descending order means what? Big to small. Now this is the biggest, 200. Whole number part is 200, biggest. 22, next biggest. 20, next one. Here also 20. Now confusion for these two. 20, 20. Whole number parts same are there. Then see first decimal. Here first decimal 2, first decimal 0. So this is the greatest. So that is why in descending order, bigger first one, smaller second one. So out of these two, first one this, and second one this one. Why you are writing big to small now? So biggest, next one. In 2, next decimals after 20, whole number parts are 2, 2 are there. So, but to, confusion here also, 2 and 2. So, which is the greatest? If whole numbers are same, then check first decimals. Here first decimal is greater. This first decimal is smaller. So, this is the biggest. We are writing big to small now. Big one write first, small one write next. Now, 200, 22, 20, 20, 2, 2. Confusion 20, 20, 2, 2. So 20, 20, same now, whole numbers, then see first decimals. Now similarly, 2, 2, decimals same, whole number parts same now, then same, check first decimals. In case first decimals also same, then check whole numbers are same, first decimal also same, then check compare second decimals. Like that, you have to arrange the numbers in ascending and descending order. Thank you for watching.